be me, 4 or 5 years old. Grow up on the countryside. Maybe 5 or 6 houses in the area, a small town 3 to 4 kilometers away. Out playing with my wooden sword in a field near my house. See something / someone moving around in a ditch. Being a naive kid, I walk up to him / it. He's big and covered with black fur, he looks kinda like Sully from Monsters Incorporated, but this was way before the movie came out. Try to talk to him but he just growls at me. He reaches out and takes my sword from me. Then he bolts and runs away along the ditch. Crying like a bitch. JPEG. Later that night. Sitting at dinner table with dad. He asks me what I've done today. I tell him that I made a new friend. Well, isn't that fun? What's his name? I don't know, he didn't tell me. Fast forward a couple of days. Keep seeing him almost everywhere I go, as long as it's close to a ditch. He never walks anywhere but in ditches. Muster up courage to ask him what his name is. He tells me that I can call him Dinton. He tells me that he hates children and that he doesn't want to talk to me. I don't remember much of this, but my dad told me about how I always talked about Dinton with him. According to 4 to 6 year old me, he was mean and angry all the time. I was scared of him but also felt sorry for him. And he has told me about the stories that I told him back then when I was a little kid. Be at daycare. 5-ish years old. All the kids ask each other if they believe in Santa, the Tooth Fairy, Jesus, etc. Tell them that I don't believe in any of them. But I believe in Dinton, I had said. I started telling the other kids about Dinton. Some of them start to cry. The kindergarten lady calls my parents to tell them that I intentionally scare the other children. Be almost 6. Walk with best friends to the kiosk in town. They're 2 and 3 years older than me. We buy 1 ice cream each and some candy. Then we walk home. They decide to stay in town at a friend's house. I don't know him, so I decide to walk home alone. Eventually I pass a small playground next to where I live. See Dinton in a ditch by the side of the road. He jumps out and throws my ice cream on the ground and laughs. Cue the waterworks. GIF. I ask why he did it. He told me that he likes to make children cry. He then took the ice cream stick from the ice cream and said that it was his keepsake. Be 6 or 7. Tell my mom that we must start putting coffee beans on the front stairs. She asks me why. I say that Dinton loves coffee and that he has told me that he often sneaks into our kitchen when everyone is asleep to eat our coffee beans. Mom and dad are obviously concerned and start locking the front door. They say that I can't talk to Dinton anymore and that I should ignore him if I saw him again. Fast forward maybe 3 months. Driving to the city to visit my uncle. I point to an old stone bridge and exclaim, "Mom! That's Dinton's house." My mom thought that it would be fun if we explored the bridge since none of us had been there before. Walk down the small road to the bridge and then we walked under the bridge. There I found 20 plus ice cream sticks. My mom was a little superstitious and wanted us to return to the car as quick as possible. When I was 7, my family moved to Portugal for 7 months. Forget entirely about Dinton and never talk about him to anyone. We had planned on living there for 1+ years, but my grandma was diagnosed with cancer, so we moved back. Walk through the woods down a small trail that led to my grandma's house. See Dinton a couple of meters down the trail. He's really skinny now. He looks like Toot Toot covered with fur, like a stray dog. Tell him that if he's going to be mean he can go away. He looks sad, then angry, and then he just goes away. See him a few more times after that day. Not afraid of him anymore, he's not the big scary monster from my childhood. He looks weak and sick. Dinton told me that since our house had stood empty, he hadn't eaten for 7 months. He also told me that he'd missed me. Told him to go away. I was busy being sad for my grandmother. Never saw him again after that day. I'll always regret it, Even if I hated him, I think I was his only friend. Found a box of old drawings in my garage the other day, the deeper down in the box I looked, the more dint and stuff I found. The old ones were mostly of me with a big black ball with eyes behind me. Later they became more detailed and the last one was of him right before he had disappeared. He was scrawny and looked old, sick, and starved. Next to him I had written Dinton is angry because he is sad, because he is alone. Sometimes I wish I'd meet him again, invite him in for some coffee and just talk. I wonder where he's now.